was sick. Okay. Yeah, all right. Okay, so that's show foods, obviously. Tito's is this show sucks, naturally. What's your other one? Oh, my God. Did you just print that?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. What the? Oh, no. Shofu, all right. Well, look, it's not me. I'm not wearing it. Shofu's going to wear it. I'm not wearing that. I don't. My hands are up. My hand time starts right now.
Bro, what the?
Responsible for this.
Hello. Oh my goodness gracious. You're throwing me off in the very beginning of the intro.
Who is responsible for this?
Roger Snakes here with Japan Time for August 12th, 2024. We're going to get to what Shofu is referencing in just a second. But as always, I'm your host, Rogers Base. I am joined by my co-host coming in at 6 feet 11 inches. We have Professor Celibate himself. Yes. Shofu, what is going on, Shofu? Welcome, welcome. How are you?
I am 5'10".
Lying.
What the fuck?
I said 6'11", not 5'10".
I am 5'10". And why are you? Why is your sound lagging, Ricky?
Oh, I don't know. Let me fix that.
Well, we're going to get to that in a little bit. Of course, since you already referenced Ricky, let's just go straight into it. The Triforce of Awesome, Shofu, and of course, we've got Zeph. What's up, Zeph?
Hello.
And my man, the one, the only, here instead of War Champ, Ricky Cocaine.
Ricky Cocaine!
We about to have one of them episodes, boys. Yeah. It's about to be one of them episodes. Y'all strap in.
Why are you talking like a gay senator?
Speaking of strap-ons, we got gay speakers. Hold on.
Huh?
What the
fuck?
What the fuck?
He's unfortunately right.
Oh my god, bro. It's already started.
He's tragically correct.
Oh, it's already started. Okay.
And speaking of tragic, we got McDareth. What's up, McDareth? How are you?
Bro, what is
going on?
Okay, no, Roger. What about me is tragic?
Apparently, you don't go outside.
I just said, speaking of tragic,
yeah,
you said you didn't go outside earlier.
It's tragic.
The fact that you don't go outside.
Why
who does go outside, though? Mr. Nintendo Gamers himself. Coast, what's up, Coast?
I'm busy. You? Come back to me later.
What the fuck?
Okay, you're enjoying that fresh air, though. Well, someone else has been enjoying that fresh air because he doesn't have a house.
Right, I'm not busy anymore.
Hey, Nintendo Gamers!
Oh, my God.
There you go.
Oh, my gosh, you came in the middle of my other intro. Tito, how have you been, my man? We are happy you're here.
Don't repeat what you said, Roger.
I am alive. I am alive.
Oh my God. You're alive?
To the three people who asked if I am alive, I appreciate you. I am alive.
He lives.
This is AI.
Also, I want to... This is not AI. I also want to say something.
You can't kill me.
We were talking about this. We were talking about this in the pre-show. You know what, Tito? On behalf of the rest of the cast, we want to issue... That we actually do like the courtroom segments.
Who is we?
And don't listen to the comments. I like the courtroom segments.
All right.
I think they're funny.
All right, that's a different sentence.
Yeah, that's a different sentence. That's a different sentence.
We, the collective.
It just needs to be more concise. That's all it ever was. Concise, that's, quick.
That's why I haven't done it. Also, I've been dead. But
speaking
my
of someone
is,
whose intro is concise and quick, we got Viram. What's up, Viram? Welcome, Mr.
Hello,
Gentleman
everybody.
Himself.
Hope everyone's having a lovely evening. That's all I got to say.
Absolutely. Now, Tito, go ahead. What were you going to say?
My question is, okay, so I've been gone, right? I've been okay for like 2 weeks. I haven't even streamed 2 weeks. I've been gone. I come back. I was told that Fidel is no longer on the show, and yet here he is. Can you please explain this to me?
Yeah.
Because I was told he was voted off the island.
And War Champ's not here, and he hasn't been here in a while, so he hasn't revoked the rights. So...
Okay. Because I wanted to say, first of all, thank you for finally, because I've been submitting this for however long this guy's been here. So I appreciate you.
Because I think the whole big thing is that so long as it's either Fidel or Aru, it's fine. Wait, I think that's the consensus. They are both members. They're both members, but only one of them can be present at any given time. If they are both
always be Aru,
and it becomes an issue. I mean, if she's here, but she's busy packing for something, right?
It was there's like two people in the comments that were annoying about it.
I will say something because
there's a lot of thumbs on that.
Let me just talk to you, Fidel. Let me hit you up, Fidel. Right. When Aru is here, there's sometimes where you just become like. Not like you want attention, but like you are just like talking over people to say something to Aru mid conversation. It's like,
chill out on
that side of it, it's all good.
Cap,
I've never heard.
He doesn't understand the way that you communicated that. It's like Fidel, when you and Aru are together, it's like we're all at the dinner table and you guys are playing footsie. If you could just tame it a little bit.
That's not what it is.
Like not
that's not what it is.
Okay, then you explain it, Zeph, since you have good analogies.
It's more like if we were at dinner and they were having a food fight while we were trying to eat.
Yeah, I think that's more what it is. It's like it's not like they're having fun and gay. It's like there's a war going on mid-conversation.
Oh, so you know that.
Okay.
I mean... It's not like
so you're aware.
So it's intentional.
It's not like I made it my mission. It just happened.
Yeah.
I can't believe he got caught there. That was crazy.
Oh, brother.
Speaking of things happening, Ricky, do you want to talk about for a moment the thing that Shofu was referencing right at the top of the show?
Shut up.
Because it feels like we're in the midst of some digilution. What do you call it? Digivolution? What's it called?
Yeah. Digivolve? Yeah. So my theory with this image is that Hannibal is like Agumon.
What the
fuck? And then he can go down a few different paths.
It's a branch evolution?
Yeah.
You didn't even get a good picture of me, bruh. You didn't get my pearly whites or nothing, bruh.
You never really smiled, number one.
What? Are you
always smiling in
there? I never smiled. Me?
There's not a whole lot of pictures of you on the internet smiling or anything. That's one of the best ones, bro.
What are you talking about?
He's the only one here not smiling. That's kind of crazy.
So
if you have Hannibal, right, Zeph? Right.
Yeah.
So I assume it's a situation where if you have more attack than defense, you branch. So like, or is it speed, attack, defense? So it's like, if you have more HP,
I don't know.
You turn Shofu.
So pissed off in this photo. He might be like Spell Greymon.
I'm not even pissed. I'm just not smiling.
Shofu's Skull Greymon. All right. And then Phil or EE is like, he's supposed to be like, is he like just like War Greymon or Metal Greymon?
I don't know which Greymon. He's Greymon.
I think he's Metal Greymon.
Yeah.
Nah, and then I don't know who this other guy is.
Well, which one is Shofu first and foremost? I keep getting lost.
Are you fucking stupid?
That's the part that keeps confusing me. I don't know which ones. You
I'm obviously not Hannibal Buress. I'm obviously not the guy from Get Out. And I'm obviously not EE, bro. There's only one.
Wait, that is the guy from Get Out.
It's the guy from Get Out.
Literally the guy from Get Out.
Yo, can you stop posting pictures of me in the chat, bro? What are you doing?
He's saying, can I find you smiling? I'm just proving he's wrong.
Why are you playing?
Yeah, I'm leaving.
Wait, you just posted another picture of EE.
This is crazy.
Show's done
for.
Oh,
my God.
I quit.
Oh my gosh, bro.
Oh man. Bro,
this is one of those pictures that feel old because of the fucking quality of the camera.
Bro, this shit looked like it was taken on a Kodak.
Is the chat seeing all these pictures?
No. And they won't.
Too bad. These are funny, man. All right, well,
which one is the nobody playing funny? That's actually very funny. So like one of these is a heartless, the other one is a nobody. So like which one is the
Have I been playing what?
Shofu's the heartless.
Hello?
Oh man.
Can you get off my fucking Facebook? What are you doing?
This is crazy. I don't know who
you're
these
posting pictures
are
fucking 12 years ago. You niggas are strange.
Hold on.
What the fuck is going on?
Before you delete it.
I typed in 2011 Shofu videos, and it's the first thing that came up. It was from it's literally not on Facebook. It's from the 2011. It's from the 2011 Pokemon Video Game Championships video.
No, you're done.
It's literally this video.
Oh my gosh, bro!
Well, while we're here, it's literally this video.
Nah, you're done for.
Speaking of things that are done for, let's talk a little bit about all the other fighting games that aren't Double Knockout, because apparently this game is the best fighting game of all time.
Who is calling it that? Who
played it? No one. No one is calling it that.
No, it's not. Like a fucking Double Knockout.
I have said in this chat.
You guys told me it's got to be Double Knockout.
Is that the real name?
I said every time I open it, I just want to open Grand Blue.
That's not what we're calling it. That's not the name of the game. That's just what the name of the game means.
But what is the name? How am I supposed to say
2XKO.
2XKO.
Two. Knockout times two.
Okay. Both of those names are kind of ass.
Exactly.
Sorry, Seth. Go ahead.
I was just saying, for some reason, every time I turn it on, I just want to go play Grand Blue. It might just be because it's not in like a polished state at all. It's like also ugly, and some of the voice acting is insane. But it's fun, I guess.
Does Ari sound like that in League?
No. I don't know who these people are.
That's funny.
She sounds horrible.
They got like people in League of Legends costumes. It's not actually them.
Wait, how many hours did you get a chance to play the game? How long did you play?
It's still going.
Yeah, the...
Oh, really?
The Alpha Lab is still going, yeah.
Okay. And your general impression is that it's unpolished, but it's fun?
Well, yeah, because it's an alpha, which is fine. But like, I feel like the graphics, even for like releasing an alpha like this, are rough. I don't like it.
Really? I find the character models look super good. Like, the backgrounds maybe are kind of lame, but the character animations and how they look.
The animations and stuff are fine, but when they do a super, I'm like, all right, dude. This feels like Skullgirl's unfinished animation.
The supers are kind of lame. I hate that they do these like this thing where like it like darkens out the corners and they just go into like some null empty space.
Also, they need to not do the Dragon Ball FighterZ thing where when I knock someone out, it like pretends the round ended. I don't like it.
That shit slows down the matches so much.
Wait, they do what?
When you knock your opponent's like tag or your mate, like the person that they're playing as out.
Sure.
It'll do like lose control of your character, fade to black, reset type shit.
I think
when you knock out a character, it actually puts you back in neutral.
No, it's deliberate.
It's similar to Dragon Ball FighterZ.
Yeah, where,
I just want the character to drop in into the fire.
Dragon Ball FighterZ, they make it so that you both go back to the middle of the screen, but in 2XKO, you maintain stage position. So you like, if you kill them in the corner, you'll still keep the corner, but you'll be at neutral.
So it's not like a mid ground. Yeah, it's like a mid ground Sounds ass.
I don't like it. It feels awkward, and I put my controller down a lot when I see it because I'm like, oh, okay, it's over.
Oh, it's not. It's you don't have a problem with like the person keeping the advantage state.
No, I don't. I'd rather it just be like Marvel.
Oh, okay. Well, so the actual like
the game just continues. Yeah, right.
Yeah,
yeah.
It feels a lot like Marvel, which might be why it's throwing me off. Which is a good thing because like it I can do muscle memory stuff almost sometimes. Characters' assists are really cool. Ari's are by far the best in the game by like such a large margin that it's not even fair. I don't even know what her other. What's her second assist? She has Vegeta Fireball.
It's like Android 21 Strike.
Yeah, get me the fuck out of here.
The game just seems like, based on, I'm watching co-stream of it right now because he's playing it, and it seems like it's slower than Marvel, though.
It is.
A lot of that comes down to it.
Echo is insane.
There's a few reasons for that. One is the movement isn't as crazy as Marvel's. Like, characters don't
you
have
can wave dash.
The same. They don't quite have the same level of access and movement options, though, as Marvel, even with that in mind. But I think actually the big thing is hit stop is really high in this game.
Yeah.
Even like, I think Marvel 3's is relatively high, but for the faster characters, it's quite low. So when a character like Chun-Li or Magneto does a combo, the hits feel very quick and fluid. But in this game, even when a character like Ari is comboing, it's quite slow and float.
So I mean, everybody feels like Hulk?
It's like
I kind of feel like Hulk feels
faster, to be honest.
It feels because like there's too much. I try to press the buttons as you would, but like there's so much delay. It's like I have to go 1, 2, 3 instead. I don't like it.
The one thing that's pissing me off with this alpha so far is that every match I've played, the connection's been shit.
I would also like it if there was just matchmaking instead of this shit.
The lobby is like whatchamacallit.
It'd be really cool.
Fighters.
Yeah, but you see, I just want to go to a menu and click start matchmaking and put my controller down. I don't want to run around pressing A on machines and
stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't mind.
Yeah.
That.
Okay. I get that. I get that. They don't have like an option.
Some of the fucking Arxis lobbies.
Not yet. Yeah, I hate every single Arxis lobby.
They need to stop that shit, bro.
I like the fighters lobbies.
All I need is a name, a ping, and your connection strength. That's all I need. I don't need your avatar.
Do that in the training room, though.
I like having. I like the option of both, like Street Fighter 6.
Yeah, that's fine.
It'll probably have
that.
Street Fighter 6 has that.
I saw there was like a little clip that Warchamp sent earlier too in like the podcast chat of how you show match previews when you're in that lobby and how it's like instant.
I love that.
We don't even load that in. That's actually really cool.
If you're playing on the big screen, the match is like constantly playing. Like
are you guys, you say on the big screen, do you mean like the big screen in game or do you mean like
there's a lobby
TV versus
there's like one
a big setup projector screen. Lobby.
Yeah, there's like a couch that has like the big screen at the end of it, and that's like playing.
Yeah, and everyone can see what's happening.
Which
in
I think is hella cool.
Yeah, that's actually really cool. Yeah, I love
that. There's a lot of cool ideas. I just want them to like polish it up. I'm also scared that the roster is gonna just be Arcane, but like beyond. No. I mean beyond the base roster. Like I feel like. To drum up hype, they would just announce characters from Arcane because that is more they're the most known league characters at this point. So I could see people because Vi is going to be in the game.
You think so?
100% Vi is in that.
I don't know. There are still a lot of characters on Arcane that are still giga Arcane's popular.
Fucking huge. There's no way they don't.
Is Misfortune? Is Misfortune announced yet?
Bigger than League of Legends? What?
Yeah, like
bigger than the game.
Like Ezreal, Lux. Jarvan, Garen.
No, I think you could make the argument. It's so because League isn't accessible to people, while Arcane is Netflix cartoon.
Well, of course, but it's still not bigger than the actual game, though.
Yeah,
Yeah, sure, but I'm saying there's probably more people that know characters from Arcane because they're on a Netflix show versus
you mean like more casual Garen, people that have never
or
played
Tryndamere.
League.
First, sure, yeah, I understand.
I still honestly think it's so weird, like not to move away from this, but like while we're on the topic of the League thing versus visibility of like Arcane, I still think it's weird that there is no League branding in the title of this game, that it's not called League name, of dude. Something.
Well, no, but I mean, they do that. They've done that with like TFT.
No, I know they want to avoid that, but it does seem bizarre to me.
That's because they're putting Jett from Valorant in the game, bro. Like
they do that, but Roger, they do that with all their games, like all their games. Unless
not
like,
all of them. They all have attachments. It's like
no.
League of Legends, Teamfight Tactics, League of Legends, Wild Rift, League of Legends, Runeterra.
No, I was saying.
You were joking about the Jett thing, but I'm assuming like, are they ever going to add Valorant characters to this? Have they said that they're going to add Valorant?
I could see them adding one because it's supposed to be a lot.
Eventually, yeah.
I could see one. Yeah.
But going with what Zef said, for me, it's like someone that does not play League and like most of the League champions, no idea who they are. But I've seen Arcane. So like, they put someone in from Arcane. I know who that is, and I know more about them because I watched Arcane.
And a lot of the characters in Arcane are admittedly cool, but they're like very pushed into everyone's face. I feel like when Arcane was coming out, the launcher for the game, whenever I saw my friends play it, looked crazy. It was just like those three girls everywhere.
And they even released like a Valorant bundle.
for Arcane, that's like exclusive.
But I would also argue that the reason why those characters are chosen for Arcane specifically is because they were the most popular characters in the game. Like Caitlyn, Jinx,
actually,
are the most characters are some of the most popular characters in the game.
Like, no, are all the characters we know for the game already, or are there characters that have been announced that aren't playable?
No.
So the characters in Arcane are they were added like later on in League's life. Some of them are old now, like Vi and Jinx are old by now, but
Caitlyn's super old.
She's ancient now. She's one of the originals.
Echo's newer. Yeah, so Vi's newer.
Those characters all were like one of the few who had an ongoing connected intertwined story with all kinds of lore and stuff. Right. So it was the easiest, I think, to make a show on. The most popular characters, I think, are like Ahri.
Yasuo.
Ahri got a $500 bundle.
Yes.
Yeah.
Where's on the game.
$500 bundle. Yes. What is even included
in that? It's just the skin.
It's a skin.
It's like an extremely skin for a pro player, and the pro player gets
$500 for a skin.
Yeah,
you'd be surprised.
People do.
You're broke ass.
There's no reason for that.
I mean, that's just what Riot does sometimes. It's like I remember.
Also, I think I can see Caitlyn not making it in, but I can see Jinx and Vi 100% because
Vi 100%.
Jinx has the little traps that she can throw, which would make her very interesting.
They showed Jinx. When they first announced the game, they showed Jinx.
Yeah. Oh, she.
Yeah, Jinx is in the game, I thought.
She's not playable, but they showed her.
She's not playable? Wow, that's a...
Katarina's also... Like, Katarina's the character they've been using to test everything and, like, implement, like, mechanics and shit. But they said in an interview that they, like... They did so much to her that they don't know where she is in... like the meta of the game, so they're like retooling her right now.
Also, that's one of the funny things is Katarina was one of League's flagship like title main characters.
Yep.
But she's faded into
put Kog'Maw in the game.
No one putting Kog'Maw in the game, bro.
And they need to make it so if you kill Kog'Maw first, he starts running around when my other character comes
in. And then you take 50%.
Yeah.
No, but like there are so many characters in that game that are like that are super old, that Garen, Ezreal, I mean, I'm not even like Jax, Jarvan, fucking, you know, is Jace in the game? Jace probably gonna be in the game, but he's Arcane.
Gonna be in for sure. Like, he'd be a stance character, so he's so
but sleek. like Lee Sin, what the fuck? Like,
he has to be in
Master Yi. Like, I can keep going, like,
keep him out of
really just want
regardless of who they add.
If they put Misfortune in, I'll be happy and I'll play the game. That's who I want. I want Misfortune. Give me the pirate.
The issue is there's so many candidates for characters that have guns, and I feel like
there's a lot of characters
you can make that fun.
Make Misfortune a zoner. I'm playing her.
What do you
I just hope that, however,
make Heimerdinger a doll character.
Hey.
Whoa.
Jeez. I was just going to say I want to see a variety of archetypes, because like at the moment with the six, there isn't actually that much archetype variety.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're pretty samey. There's three bodies on the...
Yeah, in the cast of
Darius,
six.
Alawi, and Braum.
Yeah. It's three big bodies, three small, really. And they have none of the like OG main characters. There's no Garen, there's no Ryze, there's no Katarina. No Teemo. Teemo's gonna be in.
No,
he's coming.
I think.
No. They say they're like it's really hard to put fucking Yordles in this game. Like, I'm pretty sure they said that.
The fuck, you just called me
Yordles, man.
I mean, if they can put Charlotte in Granblue, I think they can put like Poppy in the game.
And Rocket and like Marvel Infinite.
Actually, if they pick a Yordle, it'll be Rumble because he's in the mech.
I don't even know what the fuck words y'all say it anymore. I gotta leave this conversation.
Yordles are little furry dudes, right?
Who was the one that was in Arcane? It's gonna be that one.
Heimerdinger.
It's gonna be him.
Bro. Heimer?
I'm right there with you.
What the fuck is a Heimerdinger?
Bro, he's a dude. Yeah, he got like a brain afro and he puts them turrets.
That's the guy for sure.
Yeah, bro, he got them turrets. Raise your dongers, chat.
If you're playing the game and you have to lane against them, you just go AFK.
Interesting.
Put Nasus in the game, and then every time I use my quarter circle forward, I do more damage.
Well, Ricky, League has like 180 characters at this point. Playable.
Okay, but how many do you think are going to make it into this fighting game?
Like 20?
At the start, 20.
Have they said the roster?
No, they haven't said it. Oh,
I could see like
yet.
20, honestly. 20.
How many are playable in the alpha currently?
Six.
Like eight?
Just six.
Six. Oh, man. So there's a lot left.
But it's an alpha, so it's going to be a while.
The one thing that's like bugging me about this game is that a lot of the clips I've been seeing people get like 50 hit, 60 hit combos in this game. And I just don't think the game needs that.
No game really does any like those.
Well, it's like Marvel effect because that game had fucking infinites that like weren't supposed to be in the game.
Yeah, yeah. Is this also long ass combos? So what they're obviously trying to do is like get people who don't play fighting games to play this, and long ass combos mm-hmm. are the thing people that don't play fighting games hate the most.
Yeah, I saw an interesting discussion on Twitter of like. Someone try to take the opposite stance on that. It's like, yes, it's important to obviously you have to get in people who don't play fighting games, otherwise you know you don't have a large enough player base, but at the same time if you want the game to not just fade out, it has to be the depth has to be there for the people who do play fighting games.
And I'm part of that group because I actually don't like how I don't like the controls in that game really. I forget the buttons all the time, dude. I'm like, how do I grab, how do I like, I hate it. Grand Blue has done it the best by far.
Does it feel like a pad game, or does it feel like a fight?
It's neither.
Real? Wow. Okay. Sure. All right. That tells me everything. Thank
because
you.
There's no motion inputs, you got to do like all your specials with a button, but they're also directional inputs. So it's like
every sweeper in the game is down input. It's weird.
You could argue that it's pad like, but like it's very strange.
That's really weird.
Hmm. Okay.
They probably designed it that way, though, because they were like, new players aren't going to spend, you know, money on fight sticks and shit like that, so...
I think they just need to hit, like the middle ground. I like the way all the modern fighting games are doing it, where, like, there is a... what's called a casual mode, and then
the closest thing they have to that is, when you pick, like, your characters, you can pick, like, a playstyle thing. Mm-hmm. And if you pick... Yeah. The fusion mode or whatever, the pulse. You can just
pulse?
Yeah, it turns your controls into Dragon Ball Fighters.
Sure.
See, the thing you were talking about, like what's going to get casuals into this or whatever, but like the one thing that I'm thinking that I haven't really seen from any of the stuff they've shown of it yet is like, have they announced that they're going to do full on alt costumes? Because I feel like
if you
there's an Ari costume on the battle pass.
It's a Riot game. All their money is going to come from. Yeah,
that's what I was going to say. I feel like that's where they're going to make the money from, the casuals or in the skins and bringing over all,
especially
the skins from League of Legends.
Have they said it's going to be free?
Yeah,
I think it's
going to be the game to be free.
Yeah. So then there's going to be about 250 skins at launch.
Yeah, right.
It's a Riot game. It's going to be free, and there's going to be a million things to buy. That's just their MO.
I'll tell you, I'm just happy they're actually doing free characters. Because that was like the one thing with this game is like, if they're going to make it free, are they going to charge per? I mean, but like, to what extent? You're right.
You spend some time playing and you unlock them just like every other.
Yeah, but my thing is like, how much time? I guess that was my concern. Is that's how much time does it take to unlock stuff?
If they're priced like modern League skins too, I'm not ever buying them. Or Valorant prices, get me out of here.
Valorant is way much worse than
the Valorant character. Valorant characters like ten bucks when they come out right away.
Don't they have like crazy
$10 for a gun skin?
No. There are 100, 100.
Everybody relax. Everybody relax.
For like a bundle.
There's like it's like every game. There's like a super special one.
But like generally, one gun skin is like $10 generally.
That's what I thought. Okay, that's what I thought.
I mean, it depends on the gun, but obviously, like
a gun skin is fine because that's what you see.
A knife skin is like 40, 50 bucks.
Because like that's one of the funny things to me. In Overwatch, with how much money people would spend on skins when you're looking at your hand the whole game. You just spend, it's just how other people view you. It's just funny.
I'm fighting a Riot player right now, by the way.
They suck at their games. Every time I've played a Riot player in League, I've had to turn my chat off.
Okay, if I beat them...
How do you know you're fighting a Riot player? Do they have like a little avatar next to them?
Yeah, if they have Riot in their name, then yeah.
Are the employees required to call themselves Riot Blank?
Normally, yes. For like their forums and stuff, you normally have Riot something else.
Yeah.
Oh.
And then you can't, as a non-Riot employee, put Riot in your name at all.
And I don't like that because Riot employees don't know what the fuck be going on in their games because they joined the game and they got Riot in their name and everybody's on their best behavior.
I'm pretty sure Riot employees like,
yeah, they need to go on. They have to have like undercover shoppers, dude.
They make changes to the game that they play if they're getting shit on. They're like, okay, I got destroyed by this Omen. All right, I'm gonna nerf Omen this patch.
I don't. I'll think
do
that's
it in real
true
time too.
I don't think that's true.
And yeah, for the chat, I don't even know if we mentioned it really that much, but the inputs for supers in this game are just Smash Bros. You don't even have the option of doing quarter circle. I don't think. Do you?
Just no, you don't.
Accessibility for everybody. No. I expected it to be that way though.
Yeah, I don't mind weird that. It's so forced.
I think in the long run, they should make a separate mode that lets you do directions.
Yeah, if Street Fighter can do it, I think your game can do it either as well. I mean,
why? Why does it need to be that way though?
I don't know. I don't like the control scheme at all.
Let's see.
Small nitpick. I wish these games would have like a thing where you could just change those symbols to show like your PlayStation button or whatever controller you're using. Instead of it's showing
like the button format.
Oh,
yeah.
Instead of S1.
Yeah.
Because when I want to learn combos, I get confused. I wish there was just a way you could like press.
Some games let you do that.
Yeah, some games do. I hate when they don't because I just get like confused. I wish it would just let
Soul
you
Calibur
just
is the worst for that, dude.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, no, even what's the other one? I don't even think Street Fighter. Does Street Fighter let you do it?
Granblue. I think Granblue does, right?
Yeah, Granblue.
Yeah, because I was playing it with a PS5 controller the other day on my PC.
Yeah.
That was actually always the thing that like if I'm watching people combo and their inputs are their controller inputs rather than the moves, it's like, bro, I don't know what X is for you. Just
yeah,
change it to light, medium, heavy.
Yeah, right.
It's just an option.
Yeah, I think quite a few modern fighting games have that as an option now.
Yeah, because this one is just like, especially this game, it has like a different type of, because they all have different ones. It's not like
they have two
agrees.
Special buttons and a light, medium, heavy. It's weird.
Yeah.
And then for this game specifically, have they said within the alpha how long it's going to last, and then also when the actual game
ends? Alpha's done in like 5 days.
Yeah.
Okay. And the game is still scheduled for next year, right?
I think.
We don't even know.
So the assumption is that there's going to be like a beta or something next year?
I don't think they even have a release window.
Really?
I feel like if at this point they're having an alpha for a fighting game, it's probably like a year, year and a half out max.
Min.
I mean, they took their sweet-ass time up to this point. Who knows?
That's
not your average fighting game, that's for sure.
Yeah, I guess.
That is true.
Have any of you played duos or tag team, like two people?
I've played against them.
I've heard it's incredibly fun, and most people that have done the duos have been saying that it's the most fun way to play the game.
Duos is how I played the game at Combo Breaker. That was when I first.
Is it not meant to be played that way? Because that was my confusion. It's like, is this game competitively meant to be played?
Whatever you want.
It could be played either way, I guess.
But what's gonna be like the when they go to Evo? Are they expecting?
Yeah, like I don't think it's gonna be a multiverse situation where they're making it for that.
Okay. I assume they can just enter however.
Yeah.
Oh, you think? Okay. They could dead ass if they want to do 2v1. Okay.
I could see it more of like a side event.
Really?
Unless crazy. The community for this game decides they want duos to be the main thing, I definitely could see that as like a side event thing.
Because you could do that in the lobbies. Like you could be two people versus one. It's not like
sure.
So.
I know there have been
it
few.
Doesn't force you to play four people?
No,
it doesn't.
Two people playing against one person.
Yeah.
There have been a few.
Chris G and Justin Wong.
Justin Wong.
You Wong for that.
What?
Shut up.
Hold on, I'm leaving. Hold on.
Thank you. Anyway, continue, Roger.
Yeah, I mean, is there anything else to talk about when it comes to Double Knockout? Otherwise, we can move on to any other game. Well, that's the name of the game. That's
not
how
the fuck
game.
It's not the name of the game.
Man. So we're just saying 2XKO then.
That's the name of the game. Yeah, yeah, it's like the title that it is pre-given.
All right, if that's the way it's pronounced, that's the way it's pronounced. Let me ask you a question. Hey, Fidel.
Yes.
How do you pronounce the new Fox Girl's name from Honkai Star Rail? Because I know you've been playing that too.
Is it Yun Li? No, she's not in there. What's her name again? Damn it, I forgot. I don't remember her name.
Have you played through the whole? Have you played through the whole new expansion so far? Have you done all the new companion stuff? Did you do your pulls?
I did my pulls. I finished up to the end of that the mission where like they go to the underground cell or whatever with the robot thing.
You're all caught up. You're caught up. Same way I'm caught up. Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Oh, you did it on stream. So how are you liking streaming it?
No, I did not do it on stream. I just did it. I'm telling you, I could not play this game on stream, man.
Telling you, it's a good stream game.
No, bro, I can't stand it, man.
It's the only one that I think is a good stream game.
I can't do it, man. They talk and they talk and they talk and they talk. There's no, I just can't do it, bro. But I mean, I enjoyed the story.
Mental stimulation when he streams.
I do need mental stimulation. At least
give me at least one stimulation. Talk to the chat while they're yapping. Who cares?
Yeah. See, that's, I wonder if like, I don't like it.
I wonder if in like 10 years,
yeah,
long games will have the option to just have like Subway Surfers on the side for people like this.
I hope so. I hope so. I really do.
I think you need to get your ADHD diagnosed.
No, bro. I just can't. I don't think the dialogue is even that great for them to be talking for like 30 minute stretches.
One thing I hate about Hoyo games is when they're like, Terminator X 52,000 is in hyperdrive right now. Like they just
That's
why I have pretty much stopped playing Zenless since the last show. Like because it's a lot of stuff like that.
Be yapping,
it's all stuff like that in Zenless.
I'm still on
the interlude mission before I get into the next chapter. Because every time I turn it on, I'm like, all right, today's the day. I'm going to get through it because I really do want to get to the next portion. People have said the next portion's good. And it's literally that. It's like you go to the video store and then it's one little mission and it's just nonstop.
Yeah.
And I'm at the point where like it's not even stuff that you can skip. You know how sometimes you're doing like the side missions and it gives you the summary?
Dude, Hoyo games don't let you skip their shit. They're, it's insane.
It's all, but see, Zenless at least they have a skip button. Zenless
dialogue, and it actually summarizes it.
I want that. Yeah, I like the summary thing, and I'd like that for their other games. But like, at least for me with Honkai, you can kind of mash through it, and it doesn't really matter. Whereas with Zenless, the stuff that you're mashing through, it's like then you just go into another menu, and then it opens up another menu, and then like even your dailies are annoying to do right now. I can't.
The dailies in Zenless are annoying. That's
super. They are. They are super annoying.
They take 30 seconds to do.
The different menus and stuff that you're doing.
Bro, your dailies on ZZZ are logging on, drinking coffee, and opening your store and like talking to the dog and scratching the shit. That shit takes literally 30 seconds. What are you saying to me?
It feels like it takes longer.
No, it doesn't.
Maybe I'm playing the dailies wrong. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Like, it feels like it's taking a long time.
They take literally a minute tops. Total.
Maybe I just don't like that game then. I don't know. I want to like it.
There's a patch coming out tomorrow.
Maybe I'll try that. I don't know.
I mean, but right now, you won't be caught up to it.
Like, what, to the patch?
Yeah. They're adding
I give you my login, will you play for me?
No, I will not. Because I've done all this stuff for myself, and I don't really want to do it again.
So you admit the game sucks then if you don't want to do it again.
No, because I like
play it all over again for
this is insane.
No, what if I pay there's plenty of stuff I like I don't want to do again. I will tell you straight up. I love Xenoblade Chronicles 1. Dulcet. I'm not playing through that game again. The other games because playing through Xenoblade 1 combat is not as good as the other Xenoblade. But I love that game.
If you give me your Nintendo account login, I'll get through Xenoblade 1 for you. If you get through Xenoblade
1. But what does that do for me? That doesn't do anything. For me.
You could just lie. You could tell people that you played through the whole game again.
And then if I do it for you, here's what's going to happen, Roger. If I do it for you, you're going to get stuck like you did with Vanat because you don't know how to play the game.
God. Damn. I won't get stuck in Xenoblade.
I'm talking about Zenless.
Oh, probably.
This reminds me of the time that Roger had more points than McDerrith in that Pokemon Unite game.
That's crazy. True. And I beat him in Pokemon.
Maybe. It reminds me of that too.
That happened last week. We talked about it. How I beat him.
Let's frame this, okay? Because here we go. Understand. Understand.
Hey, Roger, what character are you using?
There it is.
It was Chandelure, of course. I played Chandelure naturally. What do you think?
And what? Now, Shofu, what character did you think I picked?
It don't matter. You don't.
That's exactly right. It doesn't matter.
I got Darkrai. I accidentally picked Darkrai. It's on arcade. You can't go back.
You're telling me you can't overcome that matchup against a guy?
No, exactly. I cannot. That's because Shannon Lord presses Beam, and when you play anyone else,
he doesn't even play the game.
Yes, but the thing is, I understand the game, and I can't, I cannot use counterattacks. Verse Chandelier, it pierces. Yes, it does. When you don't play overcome a guy,
bro, I guarantee you right now.
I guarantee you, if I got anyone but Darkrai, the character that actually you need to know his combos,
bro. When is the last, Roger? When is the last time you played fucking Pokken, bro?
2017.
Oh my goodness gracious! I promise you, a game that any fighting game that I've been playing.
Yes, Roger, but
if they pick any character against me, I'm smoking it.
It is me. I play one character. It's me. I play one, maybe two characters.
So it is a skill. And that's it. It's your only game.
My thing is, when I play a game, I specialize
in a whole bunch of excuses right now.
I mean, first off, I won the set. He won one game.
He lost over here. He doesn't play the game.
That's what I'm saying. He's over here
like, okay, but when you look at the bracket, what does it say? Right there, 2-1. Okay.
That's crazy.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter. It should say 2-0 is what it should say. It should say 3-0.
So you have to like mentally prepare yourself before each episode.
I mean, damn. I'm used to it now.
Damn.
That's even worse.
Damn.
It just happens. I just have to be ready for what it happens. It's all good.
Well, you know what does also happen, McDareth?
Mm-hmm.
It happens to be that you go to lots of fighting game tournaments. And this past weekend, we had a fighting game tournament with Supernova. Now, how was that? You want to talk to us a little bit about your experience at Supernova? What you did there? What you saw there?
So,
how it was in general?
Unfortunately, I feel like Supernova, and I get it, they had to kind of rush out. Well, the name's dumb. But they had to kind of rush it out.
Bro, before you continue, right? I turned on Supernova. I seen Steve versus Sonic. I seen the Steve sitting under a platform and putting up a wall and sitting on the corner of the stage and mining.
Was that top eight? Or so was that Sonic's?
It must have been top eight. But who the fuck is watching this shit?
I mean, Sonic's beat Akola right there, and that was that.
Bro, the first stock took 3 fucking minutes to be taken.
Yeah.
Oh my god, bro.
Yeah, but I mean, Sonic's beat Akola pretty quick.
They gotta stop letting that guy get in the top eight, bro.
I saw a picture of that was Ken versus Onin, and I think it was Hungrybox took a picture of the setup because it was a stage setup.
Everyone was watching the main
out of like 100 seats, bro.
Yeah, because everyone was watching the main setup, which is right behind that one and not that one.
No, because it was a fucking Minecraft Steve versus Sonic.
Yeah, everyone knows how it's gonna go. Yes, everyone watched the other match.
Wait, is that guaranteed that Steve is going to win then? Is that what that is?
No. Guaranteed to put you to sleep.
Guaranteed it's going
to
be
boring. It's going to be a long match.
Oh, got you.
Because Sonic is a character that can and will look to time you out, and Steve is a character that will just play for resources.
That
so you're going to be
lame
waiting
as fuck, bro. I'm never watching a Smash tournament again.
But the rest of the top eight is good.
Finally.
You know, Sonic's has gotten second at every major this year.
Yeah,
that's every single consistency, one. Bro.
Yeah. Yes, it's kind of insane, but he's lost to like a different person at each one, which is kind of nuts.
It's weird because he got second every single major, and he has good records on every single person who's ranked above him, but they put him as third. So it's like, it's just because he's not able to bring it home. It's just very unfortunate for him ranking wise. But yeah, like there was 5 out of the 8 in top 8 were all from Japan, which was also interesting because they released the new rankings of character of the players and a lot of Japan. Like Japan was ranked very heavily. Obviously, 1 and 2 are both from Japan this year. But no, that was good. I mean, Spargo pulled out Roy because Sonic normally beat Spargo. And Spargo came out with Pocket Roy and beat him. So that was good. I enjoyed the top 8. I watched some of the other matches too. I think as a tournament,
Mango
win it's fine. Yeah, he did.
More importantly, though, Junebug got 3rd on Donkey Kong.
Let's go, June.
That shit's crazy as fuck.
What?
That's an absolute king right there.
Let's go, June.
Melee evolving to this day. I don't even like that game, but I got to give it
DK and Melee?
Yep.
Oh, that's
also top 3 of a.
They got new shit 21 years later, bro.
Yep.
That game is unbeatable.
They got new shit, bro.
Mango and Cody on the rematch kind of packed them up, but Still top three.
That shit's crazy. Melee players are washed now. How they let a DK in top three? Have you ever heard of players being good, bro?
Also, some
boy Junebug is nice, bro.
Junebug is nice.
Junebug, I will say, there's a lot of people I never heard of in these top fates.
Yeah, the melee top.
Junebug is nice, but I'm not gonna lie, he had a bracket full of foxes.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, typically, what it was fucking 5 years ago, that would be a horrible thing.
But that's kind of cool that a Donkey Kong was good enough to get the top eight. I think that's neat.
Yeah. I mean, it's always cool when a character that's not so common does well.
Ends up getting at the top.
You know, they fucking change the tier list and shit.
Yeah, they were talking in commentary like, oh, we might have raised DK up a bit. But I mean, Alt is not as... well. It happens in Ult, but there's so many characters in Ultimate that, like, a lot of characters weren't fleshed out. Like, this is a random... I'm not going to do the whole conversation with the guy, but a guy was talking to me when I was at this fifth booth about, like, oh, well, I play Khorne, and now my friends say I'm carried. It's like, yeah, a year ago, no one would say that. But because Shattuck is now showing people how good Khorne is, now people treat, like, Khorne like, you know, you're carried, you play Khorne.
Khorne been good. I've been saying.
Yeah. Just no one played Khorne. But it's like...
Are you going to say... So it's basically just based on whoever's getting results in that exact moment, and then if anyone gets results at all... with the character, even if nobody's talked about them, then all of a sudden that character's top tier now.
Yes.
Yep.
Pretty much. But until people say that, everyone thinks every single character in the game is bad, unless a top player is playing them.
That's correct.
It happens when your fandom is potentially one of the stupidest in all the fighting games, but yeah. It is what it is. Right.
Yeah, that's the thing that happens in a lot of fighting games. A lot of fighting game communities are kind of like that.
Well, it's the rest of the event, though, how was the rest of Super as an event? Like, how was it? Was it fun compared to...
It's a step down.
You said you met Spiff, too?
Alex wasn't there, but everybody else was. From the Spiff booth.
They're moving around.
Now, can I tell... this is, like, I'm not even trying to bake, but it is going to come off like I'm baking. This is a real 100% true story. I did not go this weekend, but I'm nearby, and there's a Chick-fil-A. Y'all know... We all know the Chick-fil-A. There's a Chick-fil-A right there, okay? So I'm with my friend, and she's like, "Oh, what's this thing?" And I was like, "Oh, it's a Smash Summit going, blah blah blah."
Yeah, what the fuck
are
you doing?
Are you good? You're doing Trick Summit right now.
You didn't
good?
Even have to say that. Dude.
Are you good?
You don't understand. Fuck, Ricky only goes out with men, so it's really shocking.
Thank you, Zeph. No, you're right, Zeph. I'm sorry. Zeph, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right, continue your story. I'm sorry.
That's why he was doing Trick Summit. I get it. Yeah. Okay. Anyway.
All right. That's my bad.
So she was like, "Yo, what is this? What is this like event?" And I was like, "Oh, it's like a Smash thing." She goes, "Okay, cool." And the line at Chick-fil-A was long as shit. So we're like, "Oh, let's go inside." So we go inside and we're eating inside. And five Smashers clearly fresh out of going 0-2 in pools come in. Nigga. The waft that they brought in
was
crazy. And I'm
how do you overpower a fast food joint?
Bro, style? Bro, we were in a Chick-fil-A, bro. I swear on everything.
I should just smell chicken and fries no matter what.
It was insane. So I was like, yeah, thank God, you know.
I mean, in the venue, it didn't really. There were some people, but like
it might just be them. Bad. You know, I'm not making a generalization about everybody. I'm saying that group of four or five.
Thank
you, booty ass.
That shit is too commonplace, bro. It's actually insane. Yeah.
It's not even just a Smasher thing. Specifically, though. It's just
priorities are messed up, man.
Bro, the worst I think I've seen is probably a card game tournament.
Yep, TCG.
Oh, TCGs are insane. Are ravenous.
That one dude got banned from Magic events because dudes
because they'd rather get washed in the game than wash their ass.
I mean this as a general topic of conversation, whether it's like
they cleaned out, they cleaned up. You feel me?
Trading card games or whatever. Like, why? Not shower. I don't understand.
Me being in the shower is me wasting precious time I could be playing my damn game.
Right,
man.
I could be doing tech right now.
Or eating Cheetos.
They're not people that do that aren't well adjusted. You can't have the same thought process. They don't value showering and hygiene.
People aren't well adjusted,
same...
but when I talk to them, I don't like recoil with how bad they smell. Being well adjusted and taking a shower, it's like
no. What I'm saying is they don't value hygiene the same as a regular human being.
I just literally don't understand that.
Okay,
yeah, it's good.
Imagine this, right?
You're not in that mindset.
Imagine you're in your pools, Yo, stanky booty ass distracted all your opponents. They got more than one thing to focus on now.
They got focus on his stanky booty ass.
Stanky booty ass.
Boss. Also, people are too scared to tell their friends when they smell bad.
That's too, man. That's
I would not be scared. I would tell them straight up, you smell like
shit. A lot of people are too scared because they don't want to hurt their feelings or get in a fight. But usually people care. Be like, oh, okay, thanks, bro.
Okay, so this reminded me of a story. Okay, so this one, we were kids some way long ago. But a work colleague of my mom, me and my brother, and then her two sons, we went to a water park. One of her sons did not like wipe himself properly, and he reeked. It was awful.
Bro?
And going to a water park, my mom made sure that we went no thing that he went on. We were on every time we went in the water, it was something completely different. Whatever
he was leaving streaks on the water. Man, it's unbelievable.
Did he have his mom with him?
Yeah, no, his mom was there.
And his mom didn't say anything.
Yeah, I don't know. That was just.
I feel like you how old were you guys? Mother. How old were you?
We were mother. We were kids. We were like way how kids. Like I think I was like 6 or 7.
Okay, so that's on the mom then.
Oh, you could 100% that's on the mom.
But like, yeah, it was bad.
You're at a water park. You're filled with water. There's a way to take care of that pretty easily.
I feel like that's bordering on child neglect.
100%.
That's crazy.
But yeah, that was like a very long time ago. But whenever I hear this conversation, that comes back to mine, and like, yeah, that was bad. It's like a cow died.
Hopefully he's okay now.
Oh my gosh.
Hopefully.
I hope so.
Back to Supernova. Yeah. Hold up.
Right.
So my thing is, besides the name,
held a vigil for that kid.
I like that you stopped the segue knowing what I was going to say next. That's good. So continue.
The theming, obviously, they had to change it because, you know, they can't have Smash in the title. But they also got rid of, like, they had really cool banners at SmashCon of every single Smash character, the number they are in the roster and the year they joined. Those are gone. So that's unfortunate. The arcade, well, this isn't their fault, but the people who supply the stuff for the arcade also had a rhythm and fighting game tournament the same weekend, so the arcade wasn't as good. They used to have a Pokemon like whole setup that was Pokemon stuff, so they did like you could go there and play TCG. They had a schedule time for TCG. They had a schedule time for Pokken. They did Pokemon Stadium. They didn't do that. They had like what was it, Supernova Junior, so a place for kids, but it's like okay, that's not nothing what? For me.
Wait.
They had a Weenie Hut Junior.
Yeah,
Weenie Hut Junior.
Rare.
Weenie Hut General.
It seems like.
What do you mean it's not rare, dude?
To do at until a tournament.
Until 4 years ago, 14-year-olds were renting hotel rooms with 21-year-olds.
Yeah.
That's yeah, really like tough.
I don't understand why they had it. I mean, I get it because enough people are coming from the local area and just bringing their kids. But it's that felt a little out of touch. So like, it's like I'd rather they do the Pokemon thing. Kids can do that. Yeah. So just for like an event besides the tournament and besides just playing Smash, it felt like a step back. Because my gripe with Smash Con from the very first one was always like they call it Super Smash Con, but nothing about this feels like a convention. It just feels like a tournament. But as they kept going, it got better and better. But now I feel like it's step back with this one.
Why can't they use the word Smash? Nintendo doesn't own that.
And that was in the guidelines that came out from Nintendo that basically you cannot advertise your tournament using a Nintendo brand. That's why Smash Factor is S Factor. Smash Con is now Supernova. Any tournament that had a name.
You can advertise your Nintendo tournament while you're playing Nintendo games at your Nintendo tournament?
Yeah. You can no longer.
On your Nintendo console?
I just don't understand. Like, if their branding was Super Smash Con, that was the name of it.
Yes.
Why not just go with, like, SSC as your branding? Like, just do it instead of doing a whole new name change. Especially when they draw it
Super Smash Con.
Did they just move away entirely from convention format? Now it's just a tournament?
I mean, no, not really. They like the flow up, the setup of everything is still the same. Still Artist Alley, still all this stuff. They just had less extra stuff. My thought is that probably sucks, because though. They had a rush to make sure they could still do the damn thing since they had to change the name and everything. I think that's probably why all the rest was like less. I mean, they had some stuff like EE did a talent show, and I saw that from when I was at the Spiff booth. Some people have fun with that. Yeah, Coney did something there. So there was some things. Just all that stuff wasn't interesting to me. So like for me, it felt like less. But for people who enjoyed that, there was still stuff. They still did karaoke at night, the one night,
which they did those the other nights before, or other times before. So there was still stuff. It just felt like overall there was just less. Besides that,
that sucks, because it did seem like, I remember the first SmashCon was a joke.
Yeah,
but right. It seemed pretty good.
It was just a tournament.
The last time.
Like, first SmashCon was a tournament with a shit ton of setups. That was like the special thing about it. But like, yeah, last time I thought they were definitely moving in the right direction. This is a bit of a step back, but all I can hope is, like, now that they got a name that they hopefully sticks and they'll change it again. But now that they got a name, and then they can just flesh it out from here. Hopefully, you know, as they keep going, it gets better from here. That's because I mean, it's the one tournament a year I go to still, because it's close enough that me and my friends just drive down and just go to it. So
conventions seem like a thing that Nintendo themselves is missing out on in terms of,
I mean, they
of, like,
just did Nintendo Live last year. The only reason they didn't do one this year is literally because of the bomb threats with Splatoon. They had one set in place, and there was a guy that literally lost in Splatoon too many times that he called up Nintendo multiple times and said, I'm gonna blow up the Nintendo Live. And then they canceled Nintendo Live because of that. So that's the only reason why there's not one. I'm sure there will be eventually.
You know,
we'll have another Nintendo
I don't
Live,
think,
but
I don't think the answer is bending the knee to a terrorist. I think it's more just hiring better security and more security. Like,
to be fair, it wasn't the American one. It was the one that was in Japan, and it was like that there had been multiple threats.
Oh,
and there were other reasons behind that's it. Yeah, it was different. Because the one that they had last year at PAX was more of like a testing ground kind of thing, where they didn't guarantee that it would be at the next PAX, and I don't think it is at this PAX. I think Nintendo has a presence there, but I don't think they have like a full-on Nintendo Live type thing. But I think once the Switch 2 generation kind of kicks in, I think they'll probably end up bringing it back, because it sounded from all the like analytics that people were talking about from like friends that work at Nintendo that it was a big success. So I can't imagine that they're not going to end up doing it again.
Yeah,
and it really was a lot of fun.
That's what I was going to say, is like, I'm surprised they don't do it, because they're one of the few companies that can play on like nostalgia and their like world designs so much easier.
Yeah, so easily.
And I am glad you bring up. Oh, go ahead.
They don't do it because they lose money on it.
Well, yeah, exactly. I think that's the big thing, is that they don't really see a giant return on investment on it. But I'm glad you bring that up, because there is kind of a Nintendo convention that's going on later this week, which is Pokemon Worlds in Hawaii. So this upcoming weekend, for people who are not familiar, we have the Pokemon World Championships.
Don't they usually show something on Sundays?
They do, which is what I'm going to get to in a little bit. But I was going to say that for the past however many years, these world championships have kind of become more like conventions. They've had a lot more event type things, like the one that happened last year in Japan. Yeah, it is really fun. It is really fun.
Worlds have always been like that.
Yeah.
But it's becoming more and more like that. I feel like it has always kind of been like that, but they're doing now more side event things. They're having more exclusive merchandise. They are making it into more of like a convention. And just like you said, Zeph, you know, they are probably going to be announcing something during closing ceremony this year, as they always do. Last year they had you know, a bunch of TCG-related announcements. They always announce where the next Worlds is going to be. But this year, we're in a weird situation, because we have a mainline game that they would probably announce something for, that being Pokemon Legends ZA, that we have not seen in a long time. The game is now rumored to be releasing later in the year than people were expecting. Again, we have not seen any gameplay of the game. This feels like the opportunity to show it.
That's what I've said. Like, I've consistently, I think, over the past year of doing this show.
Yeah.
For some reason, I don't know where I heard it, but I heard that we shouldn't expect any news on that game until next year. And now that seems to line up pretty well with what they're saying. So I don't know what the show.
Yeah. I do feel like they will show something related to that, though, at the World Championships. I do, whether it's like, the only thing about it is that, like, the Legends games are single-player focused, right? And so it would be weird during something multiplayer focused to then announce something that is single-player focused.
Something I've wanted them to do. I don't want PvP added, because I would like them to keep experimenting with the battle system and stuff and doing new things. But I don't see a reason why there can't be PvE content. Like, I don't understand why I can't do raids with my friends at the very least.
Well, I know there's going to be a raid event happening in Scarlet and Violet during it. They have like the Gimmighoul raids happening. And then they've got, I think there's like a specialty Sylveon that you can get for the World Championships. There's always Pokemon Go stuff. I'm sure they'll announce a new Pokemon Unite type thing. I mean, I hate to get Magdareth's hopes up. I mean, we were just joking about it earlier.
You already know where I am, so it's all right.
No, but I actually genuinely think that is a potential possibility solely due to the fact that there's no like multiplayer thing they could really announce for Scarlet and Violet. And I think that would be a sizable multiplayer type announcement that they could do. That's not related to Legend ZA. If, you know, the rumors are true and they just really don't want to show it again until next year. If the game actually does end up releasing at some point next year. But again, I'm sure there'll be some type of Unite announcement. I'm sure there'll be some type of TCG announcement. There's a rumor about them having a full Team Rocket set coming back, which I think would be kind of cool.
I would say it'd be cool for them to announce Pokken at Worlds since they had like the farewell video was at Worlds.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you guys see they're adding a non-evolving Psyduck to Unite?
Wait. Oh no, I did not see that.
Why?
It's just
as Psyduck. A playable character? Psyduck?
Yes.
Okay, that's weird.
What the
people love Psyduck.
I mean that's true. Masuda he is one of the most Psyduck. Popular. Yeah. But anything else that you guys expect out of Worlds? It's weird because obviously this past weekend, they just brought Pokemon Mystery Dungeon to NSO. And I think some people were expecting that we were going to get like a Pokemon Presents this week in the lead up to it. That doesn't seem to be the case. So, nope. Yeah. Anything else that you guys think might happen?
I don't know. We're in a weird stage. Like Pokemon is doing something that's going to take a while for once. And Nintendo is in like a transitional phase.
Yeah.
All I'm saying, right? Bandai Namco set up that Team S or whatever that's meant to be working on a new Nintendo project. And, you know.
Yeah, Team Smash is what it is.
Okay, I mean, but how'd you lose to Roger in Pokemon?
Bro.
All right.
It'll be in the vlog when that happens eventually. Oh, one thing before this is not Pokemon again. Think about Evo and, Supernova, I think I remember to call that shit Supernova. So with at both of those chilling out the Spiff booth and talking to them about stuff with the sales, I will also say thanks again to everyone who has been supporting that. Everyone should have their stuff by now. I know some people international or other things are still being delivered, but a lot of people have them and been enjoying people tweeting out the Japan Time account and with their posts of it, enjoying what they've gotten. Also being at the event and seeing people purchasing the stuff because at Evo, they sold out all the bags, and at SmashCon, they sold out all the hoodies that they brought.
Right,
and they sold a lot of shirts. It's just cool seeing people just walking around wearing the shirts and stuff, wearing the bags, wearing the hoodies with the patches and everything. So
hell yeah, dude!
More money for the Japan trip fund, man. That's great.
As an update, though, so some things. Yeah, something we're discussing.
We can call the podcast time
around Evo Japan.
The Time Podcast.
But an update on that front. So the plan is that the bundles, we're going to end up sunsetting those since we're almost out of clocks and all the bundles are on the clocks. So if you want a clock, to stress that, there's less than 10 left. And when they're out, they're probably out unless they change to get restocked. So if you've been waiting on one of those, you should go get those while you can. The booster packs, seeing as people really like those, are the booster packs and the poster. Basically, it's going to switch to a system if you buy X amount of stuff, kind of bundles, not really, you can just get whatever. You'll get a booster pack or a poster as a bonus item. And both of those will end up being sold individually. So, like, if you already bought everything and the poster was, like, beast tier and higher, you can just get the poster itself. And then individual booster packs as well.
Nice.
Plus talks of an extra patch for an extra person.
I wonder who that could be for.
Yeah, I wonder who that
Reggie.
Would be. I don't know. Yeah, it would probably be Reggie. No, one other thing while we're on the topic of announcements, though, because we did tease a big announcement for the show today.
Big, dude.
I mean, I think it's a pretty massive announcement. It's game-changing, to be fair.
Let me hear about this.
You guys are used to us doing the show on Mondays. We've been doing the show on Monday evenings for a while now. There has been talk of potentially moving the shows to Wednesdays moving forward. Now, nothing is set in stone yet, but it is easier for certain members of the podcast to be here on Wednesdays instead of on Mondays. Ooh. Sounds like most people are available on Mondays.
The War Champ too.
War Champ as well. War Champ, since Mondays are his raid day. So we are debating. Climbing. And rock climbing. What? I forgot he rock climbs. That's right. So we are debating changing the day from Monday to Wednesday for the show moving forward. And we would really, really like to hear your opinion on this. So if you're in the live chat and you want
how
the show
to move to Wednesday. How about my opinion? Fuck no.
Why don't you want now? Why don't you want it on Wednesday, show?
Because the shit's already like I already in my mind set time aside on Monday. I can't. I'm not doing Wednesday. It just depends, Rich.
I was like, you set aside a time on Wednesday, and now your Mondays are open. You could do whatever you want on Mondays. Your Mondays are now free. You don't have to hate Mondays like Garfield anymore. You can actually enjoy Mondays your Mondays.
In the first place, bro. I'm a content creator. Monday, it doesn't fucking matter what day of the week.
Well, then
I'm just saying.
Because the other thing that seems to happen relatively frequently now with our show is that on Mondays we'll do a show and then we'll talk about something, say for example, like Nintendo Directs, and then they usually end up happening on Wednesday mornings and announced for Tuesdays. So this avoids the situation of us running into problems for Nintendo Direct days of having to reschedule things where we already are doing them on Wednesdays. It's not that big of a change. But it is something that we are considering. So again, please let us know whether you want the show to stay on Monday or if you want it to move to Wednesdays. And we may be implementing this as early as the next episode. So keep that in mind.
Lock in.
Wednesday shows, so lock in.
Okay. So what's the announcement?
I mean, that's the announcement. The announcement is we're moving to Wednesday. That is a massive.
You said we have a massive.
Huge. Like, I mean, that's.
It's massive.
This
I mean,
show
that's
has
enormous.
Been Mondays for almost like 10 years, besides when the date changed.
Oh, Ricky, you made the other announcement. Oh, yeah. I guess I could also say, by the way, too, I'm leaving the show.
Oh, okay. Oh, thank gosh. There we go.
So that is the other major announcement. Yeah. So obviously, I have been. Finally. Just so happy to be on this show for the past 10 years.
Shut the fuck
things
up, bro.
I've been getting genuinely crazy.
I'll drag your ass back into the
year,
show every week.
And I can't necessarily
I'll
make
fly
it.
Over it's to LA.
I am right sad now.
I'm flying over. I'll get him.
That I will Thank be missing you, the next 3 or 4 episodes of the show. I am leaving the show permanently, and it's been an absolute pleasure. Now,
what
with
is
Lud
waffling about?
Blow it up.
With that being said, I would like for this last show to be a really good one. So we're going to talk about One Piece
a little bit. Oh, brother.
Bro, you can't.
Oh, right. My gosh.
I can't what?
I can't what? You can't, like, use. I'm going to leave the show. Let's talk as a way to talk about One Piece.
All right, that's fair. Then let's talk about something else. Actually, you know what? This is. I'm not actually leaving the show, obviously. No,
what a
shock.
We know you're not leaving the show, bro.
What a shock. But I know. But. I do actually want to take this opportunity to talk about something kind of serious. This is not a joke or a bit or anything. This is actually some sad news that came out earlier
Roger
today.
Has monkeypox.
Bro, okay, now this is actual sad news. So we were talking about Pokemon. I was going to do a transition earlier talking about this. But unfortunately, Rachel Lillis, who is the voice actress for Jessie in Pokemon, Misty, and Jigglypuff in the Smash Brothers games, it was announced today that she passed away after a battle with breast cancer.
Yeah.
Really super talented actress, incredible, huge part of all of our childhood. But yeah, she passed away earlier today. She was like, what, 47 too? I mean, really young.
Yeah.
46, man, unbelievable. So yeah, we just wanted to send our condolences to Rachel Lillis and her family. Obviously, again, so much of us, Pokemon was a huge part of our childhood. And, you know, and Misty and Jessie were a part of that, you know. So may she rest in peace. Yeah, absolutely. We had a moment. Maybe I'm not going to do that transition. Let's talk about. I was going to talk about Hi-Fi Rush stuff. Let's not. Let's talk about One Piece Day really briefly. Let's talk about some of the stuff that came out of One Piece Day.
Isn't
and out.
That a good thing there?
He that was going to say.
Yeah, of course.
I was going to say.
I know exactly what the segue was
like,
going to be.
Right, exactly. That's why I was like, I'm not going to do that for Hi-Fi Rush. So One Piece Day. They announced some pretty big news in regards to the One Piece remake that is going to be happening, essentially the One Piece Kai. They have announced that the series director for this new One Piece remake series is going to be Masashi Koizuka, who is the director of Attack on Titan. This is animated. This is the new One Piece anime remake.
They're remaking some shit that's not even, that's still running?
Yes. Yeah. Well, technically, to be fair, they did this with Full Metal Alchemist also did this too. So Full Metal, yeah, they did. Brotherhood was running as the original Full Metal was going. They absolutely did. Yeah. Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah, positive.
The manga was done regardless. So
yeah. Either way. Either way.
No, that's not possible because Full Metal Alchemist 2003. Brotherhood came out after 2003 did.
But the original show started in 2003. It didn't end in 2003, did it?
Yeah, but
2004.
There was overlap. No, but there was overlap for sure.
Hell, there's
maybe it debuted in 2009. It's not looking good for you, Roger.
Oh, well, then maybe I'm completely wrong. Well, either way, it is odd. It is odd that we are getting a remake series, but this is very cool. Like I said, the production staff is awesome. The character designer for this one, also coming from Attack on Titan, Kyoji Asano, worked on Attack on Titan and Spy Family recently. The head of Wit Studio, obviously, Tetsuya Nakatake, he worked on Attack on Titan. So we got a lot of the Attack on Titan staff, and the animation producer for Attack on Titan is also making his way over to this One Piece remake. For those of you who don't know what this is, basically The One Piece is a remake series that is going to be condensing the story arcs of One Piece and sort of like pacing it out correctly. But they also mentioned during this announcement for One Piece Day that they are trying to stay very close to the original source material while also doing interesting things with the animation. The teaser images they have shown for this, which we're not going to show on screen because it will get us copyright blocked, are very good. It looks excellent. And yeah, overall, seems like it's
going to be struggling. I guess I guess what the point of this is to make the first part of the anime now.
That is kind of wild.
But also, I'm assuming the point here is they want to make the first half of the anime look, well, more than first half,
not like
look
us.
Good, like yeah. how
right.
it looks now.
Because the original, right, when One Piece first started airing, it was airing in the boxed format, right? And so they didn't have HD up until I think it was like Marineford is when they switched over. It was like Thriller Bark or Marineford, or maybe like the end of Enies Lobby.
An anime, like the landscape of it right now seems to very much be just a fucking animation dick measuring contest. Just whoever has the most stuff happening on screen wins. That's how it feels.
We all win.
Did they say it's ending to a point, or is it like just a, it's meant to just be a new,
because like, they mention in the announcement that they put together the staff of like this dream team of all the Attack on Titan and Spy Family people. Cause there's the assistant director. I also didn't mention is the director of Jujutsu Kaisen. So the guy left Jujutsu Kaisen to be the assistant director of One Piece. So
that's,
again,
that's one of the, exactly what I'm talking about. Jujutsu Kaisen.
There's clearly a lot of people that are moving on to this project that want it to be good and that are expecting it to be running for a long time. They mentioned during the announcement that essentially they put together this team with the purpose of doing this forever, essentially doing this for the entirety of One Piece. But they've already announced that this first season covers the entirety of the East Blue saga. So the assumption is that each season of this is going to be a saga of the
anime. So it's
going to
be One Piece abridged?
Essentially, yeah. But they're not really cutting material. It's just they're pacing it correctly, which is going to be great. I think when they get to spot. And the other big thing about this is that this series is partially being funded by Netflix, which I think the reason why they're doing this is because of One Piece live action being such a success. Yeah. Right. And that now there's so many people who are watching One Piece live action who now want to get into the series. And there's not really a good HD way for them to do that. They have to go back and watch the original One Piece anime episode.
Also, the average person doesn't want to watch a thousand episodes.
Right. So basically by doing it where they're going to have these sagas that are seasons that condense a lot of the material and pace out the material correctly and have it with good animation.
Marineford's going to look so crazy.
Oh my God, dude. Skypiea is going to be incredible.
The Enel fight, that fight is already pretty like cool. Where like animation was at that point.
And so knowing how certain things are working with Netflix and with One Piece. My assumption is that if this debuts next year, like late next year, and covers the majority of the East Blue saga, and this ends up being a yearly seasonal thing, my assumption is that we will be caught up in both at the exact same time for both Netflix and for the like the live action one and for the animated The One Piece series by Skypiea, that both will be linking up with each other around the same time, so that people who are watching one series or the other can then continue right where they left off from the story with The One Piece. And that and the other thing about this is you have to take into consideration too is that like that One Piece live action is not going to cover the entire series, right? Like the actors, by the time we would even get to Marineford, you'd have like 30-something-year-old Luffy running around and stuff. And like Nami and Usopp and stuff would be in their 40s. So they're not going to continue all of that.
One Piece also seems way too hard to keep adapting to with live action as the story goes on. Like the beginning makes the most sense.
The other thing about this is that, again, if you look at the pacing with what's happening with the final saga of One Piece right now in the manga, we're about to leave Egghead, we're moving to Elbaf. Like, the pacing of things, knowing we are in the final saga of One Piece in the manga, is basically leading me to believe that the actual anime will basically end a year after the manga ends, and that about 2 or 3 years after the end of the anime is when One Piece will finally catch up. So they'll have a solid 5 years to just milk the end of the series. So there's a lot of stuff happening with One Piece in the near future. But based on everything, like I said, in terms of the production staff for The One Piece, things are looking pretty good. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, as a not One Piece person, I'm like, this is the only way you're going to get me to watch the series. Just remake, new animation, new stuff. And I can keep up to it.
This also puts One Piece in like, it is kind of already, but it puts it even more into the anime internet discussion when the new show comes out. Yeah,
for sure. Yeah.
Like they'll be talking about it the same way they'll be talking about whatever current manga or anime.
And speaking of
Fidel, because like, it's not even about like the animation quality. It's just like,
it's just
like readjusting the pacing and just like streamlining in it and like and it not being like thousands of episodes to
I don't mind how old One Piece looks. When I saw like the first like last year or two, I watched like the first 20-30, like I like that old animation. It's just having it so that I don't have an intimidating wall ahead of me of a thousand plus episodes is,
right
yeah.
While we're on the topic though of I was going to say, while we're on the topic of new anime, this is also a pretty big news story that happened since the last show. There was a massive Netflix anime leak of Arcane Season 2, Dandadan, the Ranma remake. There was a lot of stuff that ended up getting leaked online. Terminator, the new Terminator series as well. This happened, it was last Monday or something? And apparently this was because of the subtitling group that works on subtitling and like localizing a lot of these series. Where I guess they had very low security. Apparently the website had one layer of security and the guy got through it and leaked everything. The OP of Dandadan is out there. It's apparently quite good. Arcane Season 2 is already out there. ReZero, the third season of that, already leaked as well. So there's a lot of
just to clarify, they are unfinished episodes.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are unfinished episodes. Some of them are not. Some of them are like fully done.
Dandadan, I know the Arcane ones. Done.
Yeah.
The Arcane ones, they're not like finished.
So. No, right, they're not. Right. Those are still being worked on.
Yeah. Plankton movie leaked too. Good for Plankton.
Plankton movie leaked as well. Didn't they just have a Sandy Cheeks movie?
Sandy movie Cheeks also leaked like 8 months before that movie came out, but that movie did come out. But
You know what didn't leak? Some of these D23 announcements. There were a lot of D23 announcements. Now, obviously, you're probably wondering why the heck we got Mickey Mouse with two guns right in the very front of this. Well, that's because Disney characters are coming to Fortnite. We're getting the Disney villains coming to Fortnite. So far, we got Cruella. We got, who were the other two? I already forgot them.
Is Maleficent?
Cruella, Maleficent, and Captain Hook have been confirmed. And in addition to them being confirmed for Fortnite, I still think it's crazy that they don't have Gaston when he literally has a gun. He's right there. How do you not have Gaston?
I just don't think Gaston is that popular.
Like, at all.
He's also like, I'm going to be honest here. compared to the other Disney villains, he's just sexist.
Gaston would be Jafar. Where's Jafar?
Sexism is crazy, bro.
Jafar,
yeah, but
could have a special with his snakes.
You got the dude trying to kill Tarzan. You got Maleficent. And then you just got a sexist. Like, what?
I mean, that's true. Clayton is right there. He does have a gun. I don't know why they didn't throw him in there either.
Dude,
yeah.
He had the most brutal death in Disney. I don't. Still to this day.
And they hung him.
Bro, that shit scared me when I was a kid. Yeah, like
it's a blatant thing. Yeah, he like his neck gets wrapped around a bunch of vines, and then you watch his neck snap.
Yeah,
it's pretty crazy. Yeah, The Incredibles are also confirmed for Fortnite. We're getting The Incredibles as the first Pixar characters. And then I'm going to fly through some of these other announcements because there's a lot of D23 stuff, and I don't necessarily think all this is of interest to people. But they announced a ton of movies. Moana 2 got a trailer coming out this November.
Is The Rock in it again?
The Rock is in it again. There was a trailer for the absolute dog shit looking Snow White live action remake that comes out in March. There was a teaser for the Lilo and Stitch live action remake coming out in summer 2025.
This model actually looks pretty good.
What'd you say? Stitch says a slur?
Yeah, you didn't hear that?
Yeah, and like the first 3 seconds of the reveal, he says the N-word, bro.
Bro, no, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't. Listen to it. Listen to the beginning of the teaser.
Wait. I just clicked it. Wait.
Yeah, listen to it. He just says it straight up. Yo, listen to it. Ricky, look, press that. Put in the podcast thing. Listen to that. He says it.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
There's no way.
That is actually kind of crazy. Yeah. It's not, he's not saying it, but it sounds close enough.
Nah, he definitely said it. He's pushing
but
the
But he has the pass. Of course he can say it. He's colored. And like he's blue and stuff.
I guess.
He's a fucking alien, bro. What?
Whoa, yo.
He's
huh?
You can't call him that.
He literally is an alien.
We can call him colored, but not an alien.
He is. Oh my god.
We're moving on.
You gotta shut the fuck up, bro.
We're moving on. Incredibles 3 got announced. Yeah. They announced Incredibles 3 is coming out. They announced that Toy Story 5 is being released, with the plot being that apparently the toys are against technology. And yet, in the same sentence that they basically said it's going to be the toys versus the iPad generation, apparently the bad guy for the movie, and this is not a joke, this is not a troll, the bad guy for the movie is literally 50 Buzz Lightyears that are stuck in play mode. Which is like, what the hell are they doing?
That movie is going to be horrible.
Also, people are saying this is a prequel. Yeah, exactly. People were saying, oh, it's a prequel because Woody's there. No, it's not a prequel because Forky is there too. And Forky was from Toy Story 4. So this is definitely a sequel. So, yeah, they got that. They announced Frozen 3, but we already knew about that. They also teased that Frozen 4 is coming afterwards, of course, because it makes them a lot of money. They showed a teaser for the new Pixar movie coming next year called Elio. Looks like it's going to be not great. They announced a sequel for Zootopia called Zootopia 2. And now this time there's snakes. And then
there's probably going to be some art about that fucking snake, bro.
Wait, were there no snakes in the first movie?
There were no reptiles in the first movie. The whole thing is that now there's a marshland with reptiles moving in.
Where were they the whole time?
They were excluded. They were racist. I don't know. They just didn't leave them.
I thought the first movie was already about racism.
Well, this one's going to be about it too, because Disney has no new ideas. We got Mandalorian, I guess. Grogu. That's going to be the new Star Wars movie. It's going to be a Mandalorian movie. They announced a bunch of D23 shows, including Skeleton Crew, which is apparently Star Wars.
Is D23 movie. Disney Plus?
It's everything. It's D23 is everything. They announced it's a bunch of Disney. Yep.
Oh, I thought it was I didn't even know it was an event. Okay.
It's an event. Yeah.
Some bullshit where they said they were going to do, here's all our Disney game present, and it was just Fortnite.
Yeah, the people that were waiting for Sora and Fortnite,
they 100% got rid of their game studios, so those don't exist anymore.
Well, I mean, they could have done Kingdom Hearts.
I feel like they could talk about their technically they could have shown MVC, technically they could have shown 100%. Epic Mickey, they could have shown Marvel Rivals.
Yeah, but I think that's also a matter of, Marvel Rivals, definitely, but I think like certain games they want the developers to show because that's the audience that
I guess
consume.
Yep.
Yeah,
and then the new idea, the big new IP from them is the new Pixar movie called Hoppers, in which a girl hops into the mind of a beaver in order to learn more about beavers.
A robotic beaver.
Real thing. Yep. Also, I want to ask you something, specifically Coast, because you brought this up, that it's a robot beaver. Is there another Disney franchise in which someone transfers their mind into a synthetic robotic creature to live as that creature? I'm pretty sure there's another Disney franchise that has that exact concept.
It's a common trope in general.
But I do think it's odd.
I don't know.
Not Avatar. They literally have Avatar.
I didn't watch it.
Yeah, they own Avatar, right?
And they announced the third Avatar movie coming out next year called Avatar: Fire and Ash. So literally, they are just now ripping off their own ideas.
This D23 is the most like, oh my god, there's like nothing.
Is this the place where the
there's
Marvel
stuff,
stuff
but it's just
too?
All yes, sequels, yes, man.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. There's nothing about this was refreshing. It was all like, it feels so exhausting when he was like, here's the fourth entry. Here's the fifth entry. Yeah, here's this like random idea that's trying to be different, but it's just another variant of that idea. Like
something I really liked, I thought the writing overall was pretty bad for The Boys season 4, but I laughed when they showed like their Avengers,
their MCU,
cinematic universe,
that shit was funny.
And you're like, I don't mind sequels either. I just wish they felt
like
at least
why
have
are
a unique
you
animation
like,
style.
We don't need Toy Stories, bro. Like.
Yeah, Toy Story, they should really leave dead.
It,
I don't
it
know
four ended on a plot. They on do a it for kids. But also, like, Woody was done. So
I mean, they just do it for kids. That's why it's not about, they don't care about, like, the story integrity. It's like, kids like Toy Story. I just want kids to have it.
Actually, do kids even like Toy Stories anymore?
No, bro. Not
adults
really.
They make more adults
fucking go to the fucking theater.
Yeah,
I'm glad you bring that up because that did seem to be the theme for the latter half of the other big announcements, which was like all the parks announcements. It is very clear they are tailing to like Disney adults right now.
Yeah,
they
Disney children don't have money.
Are so clearly too scared out of their mind for that Epic Universe park that's in Orlando because all the stuff they announced is mostly like the big stuff beyond. Like the Avatar thing coming to Disneyland and the Coco ride. Right. So Epic Universe is the new Universal park that's in Orlando.
Okay.
Where,
so
like,
that's what I was thinking.
So like what Nintendo World with Donkey Kong opens in Orlando next year. And then in 2027 is going to be Hyrule. So there's a lot of big Nintendo stuff going over there that's now giving Disney kind of a little bit of competition.
I know like people love Disney, like the park.
But right.
I hear people often say they, as a Disney fan, they found Universal to be a better experience.
And so a lot of the stuff they announced during D23 is they announced that there's going to be like a Monsters, Inc. land coming to Hollywood Studios. There's a Villains land coming to Magic Kingdom. There's also the Cars land from California is going to have like a new variation that's going to be in Magic Kingdom. Like a lot of the stuff they announced is specifically, there's like a whole refresh of Animal Kingdom, I think they said, for like Indiana Jones or something. They're removing the dinosaur area. So they're announcing a lot of stuff. Yeah. So, I mean, there's a cool, like, there is some cool stuff. Like, the villain area is going to be cool.
Removing the dinosaurs is insane.
But they are. They're getting rid of the dinosaur area. Not going to be there anymore. Now it's going to be, didn't they say, like, it's Mesoamerican or something? And it's going to be, they're doing, like, Encanto and Indiana like Jones.
Moana, I think, as well.
Moana, yep. And then the craziest announcement of all of these is they finally announced they're going to do a Lion King land. Which everyone's been asking for,
it's in Paris.
But it's not an Animal Kingdom. It's in Disneyland Paris, and it's not based on the animated movie. It's based on the live action one.
Didn't they also show some Lion King live action movie shit?
Mufasa.
Right. Yeah, of course. So that's their big movie for the holiday season this year is a prequel to Lion King done in the style of the live action Lion King that tells the story of how Scar got his scar.
Remember to watch Side Movie 3 instead.
Okay, obviously I think it probably definitely costs less. I wish Vera was still here.
I mean, they don't have their 2D animators anymore. They like shut all those.
I was going to say do they not understand how popular 2D animation is right now and worth investing in?
Remember, their excuse is that it's too expensive. The company with Disney infinite money has said it is too expensive.
Legitimately, at this point for them, it actually probably is because they got rid of all. I'm pretty sure the majority of their 2D animators are gone.
But there's no such thing. There's no such thing as too expensive for Disney. So that's a bullshit response.
They were thinking about getting bought up by Apple, bro. There is a such thing. There is a world where if stuff goes down, Disney can just go out of business.
There is. Disney was in a dire, like, for a little bit.
I mean, the amount of money. Like, they have a vested interest in Epic now. Like, the amount of money they're making off Fortnite alone could fund.
Yeah, maybe that could fund them.
Yeah, I mean, like, also Disney Plus, like, the amount of money they're making off of subscriptions for that. The theme parks.
Yeah, that's why they have to increase the price.
I mean, they got money. Right. You can't tell me they can't hire an animation team.
No, I'm not saying they can't. I'm just saying the cost to do it.
Yeah.
Instead of seeing
Lion King, though, you can go see the Sonic 3 movie in theaters this year. And speaking of Sonic, we have one minor little piece of Sonic news that I wanted to bring up, which is apparently they delisted Sonic Generations on Steam.
That's what people expected.
People were worried that obviously because Sonic X Shadow Generations is coming out, that they would delist OG Gens. And the reason why people don't want them to do that is because Generations is known for like its insane amount of mods. Like it has a crazy amount of mods. And so people were just worried they were going to delist it because Sega usually delists their stuff when a new game comes out. But what they ended up doing as a solution is like, okay, we are going to delist it, but you'll be able to purchase that original version through a bundle that they're going to sell on Steam. So they're going to make a new Sonic retro bundle that'll have like OG Gens, Sonic Adventure 1 and 2, Sonic 4, like a few other titles in there. So it'll be available in a bundle, but it's not going to be like the main search when you go on like Steam or PlayStation or Xbox.
Yeah, it's weird though because that bundle's price can vary so much depending on your Steam library. $200.
They're making one that's flat out $60 with all those games, and obviously if you own them, it's cheaper. So that was the best solution, I think, instead of just purely delisting it.
One thing, correct me if I'm wrong, because I'm pretty sure like a DX, Adventure 2 and Battle, aren't those not on Steam? They're on like Steam in Japan, right?
No, Battle's on Steam.
I have Sonic Adventure on Steam.
Yeah, okay. I have Battle for sure.
I think they got like a special, I don't know, they got something that we didn't.
Yeah, because I thought it was like Japan only.
What is the opposite? Right now on Steam, they just recently got Adventure 2 on Steam.
Oh, that's what it was. Okay.
Yeah. But we've had it for her. But yeah, this was the best solution they could do for this, which I'm happy because I think it would have been a riot if they just got rid of OG Gens because all those mods would have just been wiped.
A big thing also that isn't being mentioned about that, I learned that the people were... I thought it was weird that they were freaking out so much, but apparently the reason is because... The pirated version of Sonic Generations uses a different EXE, so it's completely incompatible with every mod. So every mod would need to be rewritten for the pirated version if that game got delisted.
Yeah.
I am always amazed by how Sega deals with the mod community. Like
Nintendo would have just told you all to die.
Easily. They'd be like, see you later, bye. It's gonna be $60 now, goodbye. Yeah.
Wow. Well, it's because they have to. I mean, they are like, I'm telling you, half the reason Sonic's alive is because of like fan
mods.
Yeah, literally, that's it. By all sense of logic, Sonic should be a dead series.
Yeah, exactly. No, literally, it's the community that saves that series.
So I'm on the
opposite. It should have died at some point during the Wii.
Whereas, like, I honestly don't care about fan mods. Just like a couple that, like, okay, this is kind of cool, but most of the time, I just want to play the main game. But I get it. A lot of people do like the mods, but the idea that all mods keep the game alive is like, I'm not really.
It's not just mods. I think it's everything. It's like fans, the fan stuff they do.
Yeah, fan
for
stuff
this
in
year,
general,
like
yes.
YouTube,
but I don't think
mods,
that
everything.
Always means mods, personally.
No. I don't think so. I think it's just all fan projects, all fan things.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh, well.
Hello?
Hey, Roger? Oh.
Right. Sega got him.
They got him, boys.
Is this how we lose him?
Maybe he was right about this being his last show.
I mean, that was abrupt, though.
Yeah, it is like net go out.
Prepared us a little bit more. Well, it doesn't matter. Fidel.
This is just what happens when people start talking about Sonic. I'm sorry.
people just start dying.
I also zoned out.
We're good. So the last thing we wanted to bring up is actually breaking news. So basically, the Hi-Fi Rush developer Tango Gameworks has been acquired by Krafton, and is actually going to be brought back to life, as is the Hi-Fi Rush IP. So this is really cool. Hi-Fi Rush was a game a lot of people liked. And the one big thing to bring up regarding this, because a lot of people don't know who Krafton is that Krafton is the publisher of PUBG. So basically, the PUBG guys bought Hi-Fi Rush. And now it's going to live. So even though obviously Hi-Fi Rush was taken out in that Microsoft acquisition, it's not going to be the case anymore. Hi-Fi Rush coming back. We happy about this?
I don't really. I'm indifferent.
Okay.
Same. It's cool to see if that series keeps going, but now I mean, people were saying, oh yeah, they bought the studio and all this stuff, and they're like, oh, and they hired all the developers. Like, well, no, they made a call. Developers can come back. So it's like, now it depends on who goes back and if they have the same people there who are, you know, have the same vision to push that stuff forward. So I hope it works out. But as it stands, it's kind of had to be a wait and see situation.
I hope that they make a shit ton of money and they laugh in the face of Microsoft.
Yeah,
yeah, that's a good one
too. All right.
I mean, they might. Tito's excited about this.
How did McGarry lose to Roger in poker?
Well, hold on. That's not going to be.
They picked Darkrai. That's why.
Right. We talked about this earlier. So hold on. I want to wrap this up with something special. Hold on. Let me explain.
I said how.
So Tito brought up those hypotheticals. Now, he's not here right now, but we actually have a hypothetical to end the show with, a debate, if you will. And that hypothetical for this week is, let's just assume all the cereal mascots get into a massive battle royale. All the cereal mascots. Which cereal mascot comes out on top in a battle royale among all the other cereal mascots? Who wins?
Tony the Tiger.
They all get in the fight. Who wins? Tony the Tiger. Why?
Because he is a tiger. So you have a tiger that also can play sports. He's athletic. And if it comes down to using weapons, he also do that, but he's still a tiger.
Captain Crunch got a ship.
He literally has a fleet. Captain Crunch has a fleet.
You didn't even think about the answer long enough, bro.
No, I considered it. I thought through it. And Tony the Tiger.
No, bro.
But you have to take into consideration everything that that cereal mascot has. So like you said, Captain Crunch, right, has his fleet of ships, battleships. You've got Cinnamon Toast Crunch, someone says. Okay, I don't know what those things are going to do. Little sentient, little Cinnamon
Lucky Charms,
Crunch.
Leprechaun.
Can't say,
bro.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch has the fucking old guy. Yeah, he's the old ship. You didn't even think about Frankenberry, bro. Frankenberry smacking the fuck out of Tony the Tiger.
Oh, God. Booberry, how do you touch Booberry? Booberry's a ghost. He's literally a ghost.
I'm saying, bro.
How
I'm
do you stop him?
I put more thought into these answers, man.
I put a lot of thought into this. Tony the Tiger.
No, you also, did. Mario you said Big is Tiger technically... wins, bro. There's a fucking Frankenstein monster there.
Do you think Tony the Tiger can beat Mario?
Mario's not a fucking cereal
mascot.
Yes,
he is. They had the Nintendo cereal.
Bro, stop. No, he's not original.
Like a what-off.
They've slapped fucking Superman on fucking cereal boxes before, I'm
Goku's
sure.
Goku's on Reese's Puffs.
That doesn't you count.
The leprechaun is literally Irish. What? This is not even a debate. What are you guys talking about?
What does that mean?
What does that mean? What the heck does that mean?
Irish people can fight. What do you mean? What does that mean?
Yes, but he has to fight a tiger.
He's a leprechaun, man.
They're stronger than tigers. Okay. All
right. Leprechauns are stronger than tigers.
No, he was saying Irish people are stronger than tigers.
Count
Chocula is watching fucking Tony the Tiger, bro.
You're not.
No. What are you talking about?
Count Chocula?
Bro, Tony the Tiger couldn't even fucking beat, like,
who cares?
The fucking worst soccer player of all time, bro.
He lets the kids win, so they feel good. He's
Tony the
people.
Tiger's a fucking washed up high
he's
school
not even a
sports coach, bro.
Yeah, this shit is ass.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Roger?
Even in our country over here.
You're in Canada.
Can we talk about Canada or America?
Fuck no. This country sucks, bro.
Damn.
All right. Well, On that topic, the show sucks as well. Thank you all for joining us. Greatly appreciate it. Sir. We'll be back potentially.
Yo, next time, every episode from now on. Every episode from now on, I'm going to come up with a hypothetical. Everyone has to answer it.
I like
but
that.
It's not starting this episode. It'll start next episode.
You're better at it. Next episode. You're better at
it. No, it's going to be some shit. Like, the first question is going to be, like, involving terrorism or something.
Don't worry.
I'm fine with that.
No, it's even better than what Roger came up with this time, though.
Like, I didn't come up with terrorism. I saw it. I saw it in our Discord, and I was like, all right, we'll just do this one. This is easy.
That shit was trash.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. Get us out of here, bro.
That's right. So thank you all for joining us. We'll be back 2 weeks. Take care, and we'll see you soon.